get ready to run, you press the red button.
Correct.
Okay. And that shows recording in process. Okay.
In my
Strong and heavy men was rending the mountains and crushing rocks before the Lord. ghost they said, and they cried out in fear. At once Jesus spoke to them, "Take courage, it is I. Do not be afraid." Peter said to him in reply, "Lord, if it is you, command me to come to you on the water." He said, "Come." Peter got out of the boat and began to walk on the water toward Jesus. But when he saw how strong the wind was, he became frightened. And just beginning to sink, he cried out, "Lord, save me." Immediately Jesus stretched out his hand and caught Peter and said to him, "O you of little faith, why did you doubt?" After they got into the boat, the wind died down. Those who were in the boat did homage, saying, "Truly, you are the Son of God." The Gospel of the Lord. He sends the disciples to the other side of the lake in a boat. was between 3 and 6 a.m., Jesus went toward them, walking on the sea. Can you imagine the fear that those disciples felt? Here they are, in the middle of the lake, being tossed about by the wind, having little to no sleep, and they see a figure moving towards them on top of the water. They cried out in fear, thinking it was a ghost. That is chaos. But what does Jesus do? He speaks to them in the midst of the storm to reassure them. Take courage. It is I. Do not be afraid. This literally meant, I am. The same words that God uses to tell Moses who it was that was sending him to free the Israelites. It was a term used only to describe God himself, and the disciples would have known this. Though Peter was quick to test him on this, he asked Jesus to command him. He asked Jesus to command that Peter walk on the water. Jesus did so with one word, come. You know, there are three miracles that occurred really quickly in this passage. First, Jesus walks on the water. Then he commands Peter to walk. And then Jesus calms the wind. Why did Peter falter? Why did he go from walking on the water to sinking? It tells us that when he saw how strong the wind was, he became frightened. When he looked around at this chaotic scene, he forgot why he was out of the boat. We know what comes next. Peter cries out. They get into the boat, and the wind dies down. But don't miss what comes in. It's often brushed through, or even forgotten, in the midst of the three miracles. Verse 33 says, those who are in the boat, and in common, saying, truly, you are the Son of God. They praised him. They praised him after the storm. Don't get me wrong, it's not a bad thing that after started to recognize him and praise him. But can you imagine how different this passage would have gone if they had focused on Jesus at the first hint of harsh weather? Where are the storms in our lives today and during those times? What are we focusing on? Some may rely on themselves. Some may rely on distractions such as the internet, television, or throwing themselves deeper into their work. Even those who are closest to us can become a distraction. Even our closest friends and relatives can let us down at various times in our lives. When Jesus says, take courage, it is I, he announced his divinity. The disciples witnessed proof of this when he walked on the water. As Father Robert likes to say,
And it's good. Who has spoken through the prophets, I believe in one holy Catholic and solid church. I confess from the forgiveness of sins.
We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died,
Thank you.
Let us pray. May the communion in your sacrament that we have consumed save us, O Lord, and confirm us in the light of your truth. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
We have several announcements. This coming Tuesday is the solemnity of the Assumption of Mary, body and soul into heaven. At the end of her earthly life, it is a holy day of obligation for all Catholics. This coming Tuesday, August 15th, we will have a Mass, 6:30 Monday night, 7 o'clock Tuesday night, also a medium Mass on Sunday morning. Details are in the bulletin. We also have the start of school, our new school year for the St. Mary's School. Please keep it in prayer. It begins Wednesday, August 16th. And we also have begun a relaunch of our youth group. 6th through 12th grade is junior high and high school. It meets on Wednesdays, 6 o'clock here at St. Mary's. Please pray for its success and invite children, grandchildren, individuals who have to be Catholic to join us if you like Wednesday, 6 o'clock. But mainly pray for its success and reach to the young church.